Good morning, everyone. It's a glad welcome we bring to you this morning, filled with desires, hopes, and dreams. Now, I welcome our principal sister Amy and our lecturers and my fellow students for today's session. I'm Vasavi from BSc 3 Electronics, your host, along with Unnati from BSc 2 Statistics and Namreen from BSc 2 Electronics, here to welcome you all for today's Spark session. As you people know, Spark sessions in our college are conducted by every department to encourage students to come out and share their knowledge. Now, what is Spark session?
Spark stands for sharing of past and recent knowledge.
Yes, absolutely right. It stands for sharing of past and recent knowledge. So now I request Unnati to present on online learning platforms. Unnati, I have made you the presenter. You can start. Unmute yourselves.
Thank you, Vasavi. And is my screen visible? Okay. A very good morning to one and all present here. I am Unnati from BSc Statistics second year. And today, I will be sharing my knowledge on the topic online learning platforms. So, as we are all aware of online learning, it is the use of technology for the benefit of the student. Online classes have become common over the past few months due to the pandemic situation. And these online learning platforms have been an aid to man in these hard times. So, e-learning or online learning, a learning system based on formalized teaching but with the help of electronic resources is known as e-learning. The use of computers and the internet forms the major component of e-learning. It can also be termed as a network enabled transfer of skills and knowledge. Earlier, it was not accepted wholeheartedly, as it was assumed that this system lacked the human element required in learning. But today, as we all know, it is one of the most popular ways of learning and it is considered more efficient too. So, e-learning is based on formalized learning, as we've discussed, and it is provided through electronic devices such as computers, tablets, and even cellular phones that are connected to the internet. This makes it easy for users to learn anywhere, anytime. So to understand better how e-learning benefits organizations today, let's look at the past. Elliot Mazey coined the term e-learning in the year 1999, marking the first time the phrase was used professionally. In the years since, e-learning's reputation has gone from strength to strength. But what factors have facilitated e-learning in becoming the most popular way of delivering training today? Let's see. So the internet. Prior to the rise of the internet, many relied on printed manuals, CD-ROMs, etc. for learning and training. The rise of the internet allowed organizations to abandon one-dimensional practices and utilize the flexibility of e-learning. Development of multimedia. As e-learning progressed, the ability to integrate elements such as images, videos, audio, and graphics proved to be a more reliable way of keeping learners engaged compared to the traditional learning. Next, well-built learning management systems or LMS. They have become more sophisticated, moving from locally installed to cloud-based systems, with organizations increasingly applying them to execute many forms of training. So today, we are going to look into some of the well-known online learning platforms. They are Zoom, Cisco WebEx, GoToMeetings, and Skype. Zoom Video Communications Incorporated, or Zoom, is an American communications technology company headquartered in California. It provides video telephony and other online chat services through a cloud-based peer-to-peer software platform. It is also used for teleconferencing, telecommuting, and distance education. Zoom's business strategy focuses on providing an easier to use product as well as cost savings, which include minimizing computational costs at the infrastructure level. Eric Yuan, a former Cisco engineer and executive, founded Zoom in the year 2011 and launched its software in the year 2013. Some of its salient features include online meetings and chat, video webinar, conference rooms, etc. How to install? Well, the installation of the app is simple. Search in the Google Play Store or the App Store for Zoom Cloud Meetings and download the application. So, following are the details of the various versions available in the app. As you can see, there are four different versions available with varying features such as number of participants, time limit, etc. The first one being free, and as the price increases, so do the benefits. The different plans are based on the different needs of a company or institution. So the basic plan is generally used for personal or when you use it rarely, very not so frequent times. The pro version is suitable for small meetings, and the business version is best for small and medium businesses, whereas the enterprise version is best suited for large enterprises, which can host up to 500 participants. Also, the free version has a time limit of 40 minutes, after which the meeting ends automatically. Skype. Skype is a telecommunication app that allows users to communicate over the internet by voice using a microphone, by video using a webcam, and by instant messaging. Skype implements a premium business model. We'll look into what that means later. Although Skype is a commercial product, its free version is used with increasing frequency among teachers, schools, and charities interested in global education projects. Skype in the classroom is another free tool that Skype has set up on its website, designed to encourage teachers to make their classrooms more interactive and collaborate with other teachers around the world. There are various Skype lessons in which students can participate. Teachers can also use a search tool and find experts in a particular field. The educational program, Skype a Scientist, set up by biologist Sarah McAnulty in the year 2017, had connected 14,312 classrooms with over 7,000 volunteer scientists in the period of 2 years. However, Skype is not adopted universally, with many educational institutions in the United States and Europe blocking the application from their network. How to install? So the installation of the app is just as the previous one. Search for Skype in the Google Play Store or the App Store and download the application, which you can see on the screen right now. Now, about the cost. Is it free? Well, as mentioned earlier, Skype has a freemium business model, meaning that the basic services are provided free of charge, while the more advanced features must be paid for. So Skype to Skype calls are free anywhere in the world. You can use Skype on your mobile phone, tablet, or computer. If both the caller and the recipient are using Skype, then the call is free. But if the calls are made to a landline or outside of Skype, then it is charged. SMS texts are charged too. Next, Cisco WebEx meetings. So Cisco WebEx is an American company that develops and sells web conferencing and video conferencing applications. It was founded as WebEx in the year 1995 and taken over by Cisco Systems in 2007. Its headquarters are in California. Some of its features include simplicity from any device. So schedule and start meetings from your browser, desktop, or mobile app or video device. No downloads or plugins are required. Just one button to push start your meeting. Reliable video. So exceptional audio, video, and content sharing, including digital whiteboards, ensure fast and reliable video anywhere. Multi-layer security. Lock your personal room and keep discussions protected end-to-end. So industry-leading multi-layer security provides peace of mind without compromising user experience. Time limit. So Cisco WebEx has a time limit of 50 minutes. Free service, if it's a free one, it is 50 minutes. And the time limit for the registered clients are 24 hours. How to install? Well, the installation is just like the previous ones. Search for the app Cisco WebEx Meetings in the Google Play Store or the App Store and download the application with the logo as you can see on your screen. So plans and pricing. As you can see, there are five different types of plans available in Cisco WebEx Meetings, each being differently priced based on the features available. The first one being basic and free of cost can have only one host, whereas the business version can have as many as 100 hosts, and the enterprise plan can have unlimited number of hosts. The meeting time is only 50 minutes in the free version, as we've seen earlier, whereas in the rest of the versions, it is 24 hours. Number of participants is 1 to 100 for the first three varieties, whereas the business version can host up to 200 participants, and the enterprise version can host up to even 1 lakh participants. No cloud recording storage is available in the free plan, whereas in the remaining plans, it is available. Next up, GoToMeeting. So GoToMeeting is a web-hosted service created and marketed by LogMeIn. It is an online meeting, desktop sharing, and video conferencing software package that enables the user to meet with other computer users, customers, clients, or colleagues via the internet in real time. GoToMeeting is designed to broadcast the desktop view of a host computer to a group of computers connected to the host through the internet. Like I am sharing my screen right now and sharing the view that is in my laptop to everyone who's viewing. So transmissions are protected with high security encryption and optional passwords. By combining a web-hosted subscription service with software installed on the host computer, transmissions can be passed through highly restrictive firewalls. GoToMeeting features include mobile apps for iPad, iPhone, and Android devices, encryption and authentication security, specific application sharing for showing only selected programs with attendees. Like right now, I am particularly sharing the Google Chrome application from my screen, whereas the other screens in my laptop are not visible. Multi-monitor support for client PC, meeting recording and playback for recording and saving meetings to a user desktop for later review. GoToMeeting hosts up to 250 with enterprise tier or the enterprise version allowing for 3,000 attendees. Video conferencing is another feature, And in-room solutions with GoToRoom and in-room link is another feature available in the app. So the GoToMeeting free plan is a great way to get started with quick and easy online meetings. The free plan allows us to collaborate with high quality screen sharing, webcams, and chat messaging in one session. No download needed. The free version has the basic requirements, but for further variety of options and vast features, one can always opt a price plan. There are three plans available, as you can see. The first one being $14 or 1026 rupees. The second one being $19 or 1393 rupees. And the last one has custom rates based upon the specific needs of the organization or institution. The number of participants for the first one is 150, for the second one is 250, and as mentioned earlier, for the enterprise version, it is up to 3000 participants. So how to install? Well, installation of the GoToMeeting app is just like in the previous mentioned apps. Just search for GoToMeeting in the App Store or the Google Play Store and download the application as you can see on your screen. So, as we have discussed so far, these are some of the commonly used apps for online learning or teaching. Each has its own pros and cons, which are to be kept in mind when deciding which one to use. I hope this was helpful. Thank you. I now hand over the session to Namreen of Electronic Second Year. Thank you.
Thank you, Unnati. Good morning, everyone. Now, I'm going to discuss about e-learning platforms such as Google Meet, Geo Meet, and Microsoft Teams. So first, we will learn about what is GeoMeet. GeoMeet is a video conferencing app that has been rolled out for both Android and iOS users in India. Previously, the app was released for beta users. The app has a layout and features similar to that of Zoom. Now, we will learn about the features of GeoMeet. GeoMeet is available for all. There is no requirement of being a Reliance Jio users to use the app. GeoMeet is available for all users. You can sign up using the email ID or phone number. Second feature is 100 participants. Similar to Zoom and other platforms, GeoMeet allows you to host up to 100 participants at once. This will appeal to end users who are using a video conferencing applications intended for enterprises. The third feature is no time limit. The biggest advantage of GeoMeet is that there is no cap on the time. You can host the meetings for up to 24 hours. There is no limit on number of meetings you host in a day. Now, fourth advantage and feature of GeoMeet is familiar interface. GeoMeet has smartly use the familiar names for the features. The home screen has buttons such as share screen, join, new meeting, and etc. Now, fifth feature is waiting room. You can enable the waiting room in a video conferencing call. The feature is similar to Zoom. There is also a safe driving mode to alert the caller that you are driving. Now, how to download and create an account in GeoMeet. JioMeet is a cross-platform video conferencing app that we know that we know that you can download on iPhone by visiting the App Store and via Google Play Store on Android devices. You can also download the app. You can also download other app, or you can access the JioMeet on any of the supported devices such as Google Chrome and Firefox by visiting the website. Now, how to create an account? To create an account, first you have to download the JioMeet. Then, after downloading the app, go ahead and launch the app. On the home screen, tap sign up and enter your name and email or mobile number and agree to the company's terms and conditions. On next screen, you will see an OTP. Next screen, you will see to enter an OTP. If you are registered with the email ID, you will get an OTP to your mail ID. If you register with your phone number, you will get the OTP to your phone number. So enter the OTP and sign up. Now, how to host a meeting? To host a meeting, open the app and log in and fill up the necessary credentials. And you can see a button called Start a Meeting. Click on Start a Meeting. And you can generate a personal meeting ID and password. While entering into a meet, you can preview your video and audio too. How to join a meeting? There are three steps to join a meeting. You can see in the step one case to click on the join button and ask your host to give meeting ID and password. Click the meeting ID and password and you can join the meeting. Now, we'll learn about what is Google Meet. Google Meet is a video conference calling platform designed primarily for professional use, which links remote colleagues, others for real-time interaction. Schools and other organizations can take advantage of advanced features, including meeting with up to 250 internal or external participants and live streaming up to 1 lakh viewers within a Zoom. Now, we will learn about the features of Google Meet. Unlimited number of meetings. Connect with anyone, co-workers, clients, classmates, or your peers, etc. And invite up to 100 participants. You can host up to 100 participants in a Google Meet. Live captioning during the meetings. Follow along in real time with automated live captioning powered by the Google Speech Recognition technology. To turn on closed caption, click on the turn on caption, or you can see here three dots. Click on it and turn on captions. Next feature is compatible across devices. Yes, Google Meet is compatible for all devices such as iPhone, iPad, PC, and etc. Video and audio preview screen. While entering into a meet, you can preview your video and audio. You can see you can on your camera and see how you look while entering into a meeting. Then adjustable layouts and screen settings. Meet automatically switches the layout in a video meeting to display the most active content and participants. And if you wish, you can change the layout of the Google Meet and see the every participant. Screen sharing with participant. Present your entire screen or an application window to share presentation or collaborate with the document. You can share a Chrome tab or whole window if you wish to share. Next feature is that messaging with participants. Make meeting more engaging with live messaging during calls to share files, links, assignments, and etc. And these messages are only available during the meetings. There are special controls for meeting hosts. Anyone can easily pin, mute, or remove participants. For privacy reasons, you cannot unmute a participant. For education accounts, only the meeting creator can mute or remove others. That means a host can only remove other participant if he or she wishes, but he or she cannot unmute a participant. Now, how to start a video meeting. To create a new video meeting, log into your Google account and sign up for free. Then invite others to online meeting. Send a link or a meeting code to anyone you want to join the meeting. Now, joining a meeting. To join a meeting, enter the code as shown in the picture or a link provided by the host to join a meet. Meet with everyone. With live caption powered by the Google speech recognition technology, Google Meet makes meeting more accessible for non-native speakers and hearing impaired participants. It is easy for them to follow along the captions. Meet safely. Meet uses the same protection that Google uses to secure your account data. A host has a responsibility to admit particular person who she or he knows. And this is a very safety tool for a host. Next, meet from anywhere. You can get the whole crew together in a Google Meet where you can present business proposal, collaboration on assignment, or just catch up face to face with your friends or peers or anyone, etc. Meet on any device. As you know, you can meet on any device or invite a guest on any device such as iPad, iPhone, Android devices, and etc. Meet clearly. Google Meet advantage is that Google Meet adjusted your network speed, ensuring high quality video calls wherever you are in the world. And new AI enhancement keeps your calls clear even when your surrounding is noisy. You can see your setting that noise cancellation. This means if you click on this, only the speaking person voice can be audible to the participant, not the surrounding noises. Now, we will learn about what is MS Teams. MS Teams means Microsoft Teams. It's a persistent chat-based collaboration platform complete with document sharing, online meeting, and many more. Extremely useful for useful features for business communication and school organizations too. Teams. You can imagine school teams as the houses. Like Teams allows communities, groups, or teams teams to join through a specific URL or invitation sent by a team administration or owners. Teams for Education allows admins and teachers to set up specific teams for classes, professional learning communities, or for staff members. Another feature of MS Teams, Microsoft Teams, is channels. Channels within a team members can set up the different channels. Channels are the topics of conversation that allow team members to communicate without the use of email or group messages. Users can reply to the post via images, GIFs, or by custom made memes, etc. And you will have a direct messaging which allow users to send private messages to a particular participant in the channel. Calling is another feature. Calling is provided by the instant messaging or voice over internet protocol video conferencing inside the client software. Teams also support the PSTN, which means public switch telephone network. Conferencing, allowing users to call phone number from the client. Meeting. Meetings can be scheduled or created ad hoc, and users visiting the channel will be able to see that a meeting is currently in progress or not. This supports the thousands of users that can connect via meeting link. education, MS Teams allows teachers to distribute, provide pre-feedback and grade student assignment or give quizzes or etc. Via this education team. Now, Teams Live Event. Teams Live Event replaces Skype meeting broadcast with ability of users to broadcast up to 10,000 participants on Teams or MS streaming, as you know all. Now, thank you everyone. Now I will hand over this session to Ms. Vasavi of Electronics third year MECS. Thank you once again.
Thank you, Nambin. So until now, you have seen about online learning platforms. Now I'm going to present on LMS, like what is LMS and its uses. So I'll start my presentation. LMS means Learning Management System. It's a software application or a web-based technology to plan, implement, and access a specific learning process. It is used for e-learning practices, and in its most common form consists of two elements. One is a server that performs the base functionality, and the second one is a user interface that is operated by instructors, students, and administrators. What can we do with an LMS? With an LMS, you can gather all your learning materials in one place and make them available to all learners in just one click. You can create a different group of learners according to their function or job positions. Now, you can assign them a single course or a test or a whole series of material calling learning paths and easily track each learner's progress to encourage the leaders and help your team develop faster. Who needs an LMS? A wide range of different organizations from high school to large corporations can benefit using LMS, which can also reduce expenses for things like classroom rental, transport and accommodations, instructor salary, learning material printouts. What else can LMS help us with? The right LMS helps us to save time, set unified learning standards and access and develop employees' knowledge. What benefits will everyone get to use? They can access learning materials from anywhere, from any device, and an unlimited number of times to refresh their knowledge anytime they need to, as well as they get an opportunity to collaborate with each other during the learning process. And all this amount to loyalty, motivation, and strong skills. Here are a few features that are described in LMS. I have just given here the subheadings because if I start saying it in detail, it will take a very long time. So if you want to check them in detail, you can go to Google and type www.goodfirms.com. And these are a few open sources in LMS, that means free apps or websites as shown here. There are 9 LMS which I have included, and in it, Moodle, Edmodo, and Google Classroom are the popular ones, as I have highlighted those. So Edmodo and Google Classroom we use in our college for our academic purposes. And here are a few paid versions of LMS, Thinkific, LearnDash, Edway, iSpring Learn and Tobiti Learn. So until now, you have seen about online learning platforms and what is LMS, etc. So now I'll show you how to use Edmodo app according to our students' point of view, teachers' point of view, and parents' point of view. So I'll show you practically. Uh, First, go to your Google Chrome app from your desktop or your mobile app. Then go and click on Edmodo sign up. Then you'll get login Edmodo here. Go and click on login Edmodo. Then a page appears like this, asking you for email password. Ignore it. And if you go down, you can see don't have an account, sign up. So new users or students who are new to it have to sign up here. Click on sign up. After clicking on sign up, we get to see three things. One is teacher's account, student's account, and parent's account. So in Edmodo, we have a feature called parent's account also, where parents get to see their children's activity. So first I'll show you about parent's account, how to create it. So we have to give our phone number. Something like that. And then you have to give your email. Then you have to give your password and then create your account. After creating your account, it'll ask you for your first and last name for your profile. Then give your first name and last name, and then click on create. The account will be created. As I have already created my account, I'll log in. So here I have login down. I'll click on login. So I'll get my So after logging into my account, my profile appears. I mean, my parent profile appears. So this is my parent's profile. Taneera Durga is the parent. And your, I mean, the parent student is Vasavi BSE. So you get to see your students' activity here, what they have posted or their assignments, their activities. You get to see all here in this page. See, as you can see, the teacher has posted a thing, and then in words due, if you click on words due, you can see what your student or children did not you can see what your student did not doesn't did her homework or activity. So here this student, this particular student has not completed their assignment or quiz. So I get to message teacher here. I can message the particular teacher. So when this page, profile page appears, it will ask for a parent code, and that parent code will be near the student or the teacher. So the that particular code will be near your student. If you go, I'll show you where it will be. If you go to Edmodo, and I'm signing into my student's account. And this is my student's account. So in the right side corner, if you go down here, you get to see my parents, invite a parent, and you have a code here. This code will help your parent to join the Edmodo app and see your activities. So this code you have to give to your parents. So I'll copy this code and then I'll paste it here to move on to the account. So this is all about the parent account. Now I'll show you how to create a teacher's account and what are the benefits in it. So again, I'll go back to sign up and click on teacher's account. So here I have four things. One is email address, password, confirm your password, and the college code or school code is optional. So you have to give your email address here, then you have to create your password, confirm it, and then click on next. Again, it'll ask you for your first and last name. For your profile, you have to give your first and last name and then create your profile. As I have already created it, again, I'm logging in to my teacher's account. So I'll continue with my Gmail ID. So my teacher's profile will look like this. The first thing when you come to your teacher's profile is to create a class. Already I have created three class, and I also have different colors here that mentions the separate class. So how to create a class means, in the left side corner, as you can see, I'm showing this my classes. Here you have three dots, you have to click on it and then click on create a class. Then you get the page pops up like this. You have to name your class, describe your class, select your grade, select your subject, select your sub-subject, and you can also change the color because you have colors here too for a different class, which describe a different class. Then you have to click on create. So now, as I have already created three class, I'll show you. I have created BAC1, BAC2, BAC3. So I'll go on, move on to BAC3. So here I have a class code, right? So this class code is given to the students to join this particular group or this particular class. So this, if I click on this code, it will ask to copy. Then I have to click on this copy, and then I have to copy this to my WhatsApp group, and then the students get to join in this particular class. And this whole class is about BSc MECS and MSCS3, that means electronics and statistics 3. So now I want to create a separate class, separate group for electronics and then statistics. So what I'll do is if you see here, there is a thing called small groups. I have already created four groups. So what I have to do is click on this add symbol. Then you have to give a group name. If I want to have a separate class for electronics, then I'll give electronics and then create. So I have already created, I'll click on it. If I click on electronics, I have here, there are zero participants in it. So what I have to do is members. I have three members here already. So if I have to add more students, you have to click on add members here, which I'm showing you. Then click on add members to small group. Then here you have to search for a student, type their name, or you'll get the students list here. As I've already selected the students here, that's why it's not showing me, or else it will show you. Then you have to click on add. So the whole members in BSc MECS and MSCS 3 are here. As you can see, the parent is Thaniruduka for this particular student, and there are small groups. MEC, this student has been into groups like MECS3, electronic statistics. So that is why. And the next thing is to create an assignment or quiz. So how to create an assignment or quiz? I have went into a particular class now, and then here it appears a dark blue color thing called create. If you click on it, it will show you assignment and quiz. If I click on new, it will take me to the assignment page. So I have to give here the assignment details, the assignment title, my instructions. I can add any attachment I want, and then I can assign. So if I give assignment title like difference between C and C++. Here I give, teachers get to give specific instructions. Like if I give here, write only in A4 size sheets. Then I get to add an attachment. This will take me to my folders. Then I'll add an attachment. As you can see, the attachment is added. You can also add a link, or you can also add from your library, that is from your Google Drive, and then you get to assign it. So you can give this assignment to various classes also. So as you can see, I have all these classes here. If I want to give it to MSCS 1, same assignment, then I'll click on that. And you get to select your due date. That means when the assignment, when this post has to stop receiving from taking assignments. So I'll give 11th. It'll ask me for time. You can choose your own time. And I'll click on lock after due date. And this option, add to gradebook, will show you the whole database of students who have submitted what they have submitted. It'll show you like a spreadsheet. And then if you click on this schedule for later, then it'll schedule later. You have to give us a particular date when you have to submit. When you have to submit for a particular date and a particular time, then you can click on assign. Okay, the same thing is applicable for quiz also. Go again to create, click on quiz, click on new. And then the page appears like this, asking for quiz details, quiz title. So I'll give basics of computer instructions. I don't want to give any instructions. Quiz questions, here you get to choose true or false, multiple choice, short answers, etc. So you can choose according to your wish. Now I'll give a question like, who invented computer. Here you get to attach images or any file with this particular thing. In responses, I have to click on answers. So yeah, I'll click here the correct answer. If this is the correct answer, I'll click on this. If this is the correct answer, I'll click on this and then I'll attach. If you want to see your preview, click on preview and that will show how the whole quiz has been created. And here it will show the time. You can also select the time, how much you want. I'll show you how. Then you have to click on assign. Here, again, you have to select your due date, select your particular time. Time limits you can give 1440 because it's 1440 is about 24 hours. So according to you, you can give your time how much ever you want to. Here you can randomize your questions, and this whole progress about quiz, it will be added to a spreadsheet and show results to students upon completion. This will show the students after they complete their quiz how many marks they get. So then I click on assign. So this is about a quiz. Now I'll show you how to post something, anything. So here, if we go to a particular class, here you see a start a discussion, share class materials. Here you can share your homework questions or timetable or class notes, etc. So here you can type this is today's class notes. You can attach your file from your library or your PC, and then you can post. And the other thing is you can check your students' progress, posts, and replies. I'll show you how. If you go on classes, I'm going to BAC3. So here I have members. If I click on members, I have this particular members. So if I click on this student, it will show you activity progress. So if I click on activity, it will show what they have posted and what they have replied to the particular posts. And you can also see the progress where lecturers In this progress, lecturers give marks or award them badges, etc. So their progress would be shown here. And then you also have an option of Microsoft Office. That means you need not to separately create a file or a document and then put it in your PC and then post it here. So among all of them, you can do one thing. You can click on here, Edmodo Microsoft Office. So you get to see three things called Word, PowerPoint, Excel. So if you click on Word, I type here my questions. It's opening. So here I type my questions. I can type whatever I want. And then you have to make sure that you give a proper title to it, because it will be easier for us to get from our library or search from our library to post it. So this is after you type something in this Word or PowerPoint, Excel, it automatically save into Edmodo library. Yeah. So this is all about teacher's account. Now I'll show you how to create a student's account. Again, I'll go back to sign up and then click on student's account. Here you have class code, username, email, password, etc. So class code is a thing which our lecturers give us to join a particular class. So as I have shown in the teacher's account, you have a separate code for each class. So that code you'll paste here to join many classes. Then you have to give your username, then you have to give your email, then confirm password, then create your account. After creating your account, it will ask for your profile to give your name, first name and last name. Then it will ask you to create. So this is how to create a student's account. As I have already logged in, I'll show you. This is my actual student's account, which I use for my academic purposes now. So these are my classes. As you can see, these are four classes which I have joined. So this is Java, Python, M5 and M6. So if I click on Java, you get to see what my lecturer has posted a few days ago. So these are the notes and timetables are posted here, notes are posted here. So you can download directly. If you click on this PDF, it will be downloaded into your device directly. Or you can click on download here. You should click on three dots and then download. Then it will be downloaded. And assignment. Coming to assignment, when a lecturer posts their assignment, you have to click on that particular post or it will show you to submit. Then you have to attach your file from your device, whether it can be from your phone or PC. Then you have to submit it. So yes, these are my, if you click on members, you get to see all the students who have who are there in that class. So all the students are my classmates. So this is about students account. And now this is all about students account. So with this we have come to an end of our session. So yes, with this we have come to an end of our session. So firstly, a heartfelt gratitude to our principal sister Emmy for encouraging us for doing new things and supporting us constantly. Thank you, sister. I would like to thank our lecturers for their help and guidance, and also a big thanks to the audience for your patience and interest. You may all leave the session now. Thank you very much.